They're also saying that you tend to be like a control freak. And you have to kind of let go and you know, trust in the process and not have to be so, you know, like,
yeah,
it says stop trying so hard to control everything and all the doors will open. So they're saying, you know, just have more trust and have more faith in how things are going. And don't worry, like, if things are not flowing immediately, it may take some time. It's kind of like the movie The Secret. Did you see the whole thing?
Yeah, we need the P word, patience.
But do you remember that one part where, exactly, patience and faith, that one part where it was that little sprout coming out from under the ground?
Analogy.
Exactly. Yeah. It's like you have to be steadfast in your faith and your belief, because if you don't, if you start doubting, that little sprout's going to go back down into the ground.
And you're a killer if you keep digging in there to see what's happening.
Exactly, yeah. There you go, exactly. So they're saying trust,
and just go
have
with
faith.
The flow.
Just keep, don't let the outside circumstances interfere with what you believe in, okay? Don't buy into what's going on in the external world. You have to be steadfast in your beliefs inside and know that your dream is coming true. Because everything happens based on what you focus on and what you believe in, okay? So be really steadfast about that trust and faith, and just be patient, exactly. So easy does it, okay? And again, this is ask for what you want. So let the universe and the people know what you need. So in other words, they want you to speak out more and be more detailed about what you want. They want you to be more focused on what it is you're looking to, you know, draw in. So, you know, it's like they're saying be a little more specific, or maybe put more time into put more time into envisioning what you want to happen in the next 3 to 5 years, okay? There is a new career opportunity coming to you, I would say, from 6 to 12 months, in the next 6 to 12 months, there's a new career opportunity manifesting into your life, and it's really awesome. I mean, it's it says here your work focus is shifting in a positive, new, and successful direction. So I think it was earlier in the other cards. That's what it said, right? There's a lot of opportunities coming to you. So this is really, this is really confirming it. So, you know, this is really, really great. I mean, within the next 12 months, your timing is really good. It's just, you just have to work on the having more faith and more trust and doing more work on the visualizing, the daydreaming, the, you know, meditating.
I couldn't do enough of that already.
Meditate. Do you meditate?
I'm the type A personality who can sit still, can't quiet my mind for more than 5 seconds, and
okay,
then something will happen.
See, that's what the other card, listen, is. Mm-hmm. It's saying that you need to quiet your mind. But that's how you receive guidance. Mm-hmm. And if you don't quiet your mind, you're constantly on the go, you're constantly multitasking, that you're so busy, you're missing out on all the signs. Is that making sense?
Yes.
Because you're so busy with everything else that you're not really in the here and now. You're not grounded. So they want you to be more grounded. They want you to have more moments of stillness so that you can listen and so that you can pay attention. It's about paying attention. It's about, and that's part of the receiving. And if you want your life to flow better, you have to have that moment of stillness to receive. Because that receiving is telling the universe, when you allow yourself time of stillness and to listen, you're telling the universe, I'm here to receive, give it to me. And so in turn, the universe will then start opening all these doors for you, because it knows that you're grounded enough to notice them, that you're not running 100 miles per hour, that you won't even notice the doors. Does that make sense? So for all these opportunities to open up, you need to have more moments of stillness and quiet to listen to the messages coming in. Okay? So that's what they're saying. But other than that, it's really awesome. I mean, you have lots of career opportunities coming to you. You know you have the power. Stand up for your beliefs, you know, be cognizant about your boundaries. Do things only that will benefit you, that will make you happy. And really, that's really an awesome reading. Do you have any questions?
No. I'm hoping that it's not going to come to any bad news.
I'm sorry?
I was hoping you wouldn't come to any bad news. So
no.
I'm happy. Like,
yeah. No. There's no bad news. The only thing is, you know, you have some things to work on. You have some healing to do. And most important is definitely to open yourself up to receive and not be, you know, multitasking too much and not be, you know, flying 100 miles per hour. So when you do that, you'll start hearing the signs. You'll start hearing the guidance because you are fully guided. I feel like you have three main guides, two of which are angels. The other one is a spirit guide for you. And I almost feel like, do you have any connections or do you have any feelings towards like the Native American Indian culture?
Well, not any like ancestry or anything like that.
Right.
Just when I was younger, I was very passionate about that culture for years. In my high school years, all I read about.
The Native American?
Yeah,
I feel like one of your guides is Native American. I'm sure that you've had past lives in those cultures, and that is why.
I was told that too by somebody else.
Yes.
She read some of my past lives, and she didn't know anything about me. It was someone relatively a stranger, and she read my personality based on who she read that I was in a particular past life as a Native American Indian.
Oh my God!
Even down to the
I'm
way that I
chills.
Wear my hair, and I used to wear my hair the same way, the little, you know, little tail like this.
Right.
And that's how she saw me as. I don't know if I was wearing my hair like that at that point, but that's how. I usually wear my hair.
I feel like this person is helping to keep you grounded on this earth, and because their culture was one of the most spiritual races on this earth, and they were extremely. He's here to help you connect with the elements. He's here to help you connect with nature because you have to be connected on this earth in order to manifest your dreams, and so. That's why he is here, to help guide you and keep you grounded so that you can manifest your dreams here on this plane. Because you can't manifest properly if you're not grounded. You know, I mean, even though you want to be up here, your life is down here. So you need to be focused and rooted into your existence here in order to make any of your dreams come true. So that's what he's here to do. Yeah. So, you know, that's the extent of an angel reading.
Oh, it's amazing how you hit on so many things that are so familiar and I recognize
mm-hmm.
the healing and the, you know, not trying to control everything, and that's so hard.
I know. It's human nature to do that, but just be more aware because these are some of the blockages in your life, and your angels are trying to make you aware that if you move past these blockages, your life will flow a lot better. It's totally about control and lack of trust and lack of faith, and when you do trust and when you do have faith, things will just flow like you won't believe.
Well, thank you so much. That was excellent. And,
you're very welcome.
I look forward to all these great things happening, and I'll let
and
you know when they do.
And please keep me posted. Yes, thank you. Great.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome, Simone. Anytime.